India and the European Union are currently negotiating a free trade agreement, and big business on both sides of the talks is desperate to get the deal done. European companies are eager to access India's growing market. India's corporate world has set its sights on Europe's service sector, and the Indian government and the European Commission are acting as brokers for these corporate interests. The Commission is working closely with the employers' organisation Business Europe, as well as dozens of different industry lobby groups, the car lobby, the textiles industry, supermarkets, the food industry, the pharmaceutical industry, and more. Big companies are also lobbying on the deal. All want to get a slice of the vast Indian market, and the lobbying extends beyond the EU's borders. In Delhi, the EU delegation works hand in glove with European big business. It also has close contacts with India's biggest industry associations, CII and FICCI. And with the Indian car lobby, the software industry, the pharmaceutical industry, and more, who in turn are busy lobbying the Indian government. In fact, the Indian government has invited big business to advise it on the trade deal with Europe, allowing industry to set the agenda. Trade unions and people's movements are not included. India's National Parliament and the State Assemblies do not have a role to play. But corporate India has a voice in Brussels. It has been using Indian embassies and business delegations to reach out to policymakers in Europe. But what about the people who will be most affected by the trade deal? Millions of street vendors will face competition from supermarket giants such as Tesco and Carrefour, putting their livelihoods at risk. Fisherfolk, farmers, and small businesses will not be able to compete with imports from Europe. Workers' basic rights will be undermined in Europe as well as in India. And patients across the world could lose access to life-saving, affordable drugs currently manufactured on the subcontinent. These people have no voice in the trade talks. This is why they want an immediate halt to EU-India negotiations and a trade policy that is not driven solely by big business profits, but by people's needs.